More from the Buffalo Croquet Club Six Wicket Invitational Tournament held in August of 2021 in Delaware Park in Buffalo, New York. Ryan Thompson, again, double duty as tournament director and tournament manager. Paul Neubecker, your videographer. This is a semifinal match between Tim Rapuano at a handicap of -1.5 and Doug Moore at 0. That's Doug walking in the picture and Tim sitting over there on the bench by the deadness board. In the other game, they are double banking with the other semifinal match. It looks like Doug came in and parked over on the west boundary by hoop one, and Tim positioned himself back on the south boundary. Why blue stayed there when yellow joined up with red, I'm not quite sure. The standard response would have been for blue to either attack or get out of dodge. Presented with this opportunity, Tim is taking advantage. And he'll hit first the ball he wants to leave behind. The usual massive crowd we get at croquet tournaments. He's prioritizing giving yellow a rush to its hoop rather than trying to get clean off of black. I bet that if he were closer to hoop two for this attack, he would have done it the other way around, trying to avoid three ball deadness for red. Looks like he's right behind the hoop, so he can't get to two as directly as he wanted to. Standard deadness board plus clip position. Looks like Rich Curtis and David Isaacs are starting the other semifinal at the other end of the court. A lot of folks would rather just wait and start the second game after the first one clears hoop one, but this works better if you have a tight time schedule.
For my last three.
That's my
track. A bunch of us were tied, like three or four of us.
Yeah, well, I think that year I was undefeated. My only loss was a 26-0 on an oversleep to Pola, who, like, refused. That'd be fitting.
All right.
Ready?
Tails.
It's a pretty deep hole for red and yellow right off the bat. So blue takes the spent ball yellow out of its hoop, keeping it dead and setting up something for partner black over at hoop two. The danger ball red is a long way away, but it doesn't really matter because it's three ball dead anyway. Just to be clear, that deadness board on the north end of the court is from the double bank game. Putting red on the west boundary in hoop shooting position.
Hey. Yeah, we lost a scrappy game in the doubles finals.
He plans to go to peg off this. Let's see how he does.
And then they get out. You know, that hasn't. I put that out there. Neither one of them has said anything to me about it. So I figured if they weren't bringing it up, I wasn't going to push it. Yeah, I mean, I'll let you know if they say something. Okay. Yeah, I said goodbye to your mom this morning, so I figured that was the case. I didn't know about Patricia. The cheaper one or the more expensive one?
Interesting. He decided not to run the three ball break, but rather to set up blue to come back to hoop two. That is red's hoop. Maybe he wants to make sure he's keeping red dead. And because black and blue are both dead on yellow, he can't use that miss as a chance for a croquet out.
Yeah, I mean, I got a handle on Melbourne. Make it anyway. Thanks, Dave. Studied that market when we were looking. Terrible first thing. Takes me 10 minutes to get going. Yep.
Nice rush for black to hoop three. Doug must have known that was going to happen all along.
Okay. I'm talking to you on the phone, so I don't know.
And now I bet he'll run the three ball break.
All right, bye. Love you too.
upset my rhythm, that's good for your wife.
So we got three hoops. Black is wired in six from yellow, but he's not responsible for yellow, so there's no lift. And yellow sets up for the line shot. Trying to pick up yellow for black after it makes six. The board is beginning to look biblical. Got to take some risk to get clean. I'm not sure what he's checking there. Yellow's only live on black, but he's not responsible for yellow, so he can wire from yellow with impunity. No point making one back until you have a break, since the opponent has all that deadness. Pioneer for black at two back. Calculating what to do with the one back clearance he's about to get. Red's a hoop behind yellow, but it's probably more to do with which ball will be able to attack its hoop first after he gets the clearance. And, of course, which ball has more deadness. Black passes, delaying the inevitable a little bit longer and removing the incentive for yellow to join up with red.
I thought someone was beeping it.
Determining whether red can be safely attacked or not. Looked like a beveled edge, so he didn't get the power he needed. What, me worry? Red takes the one back clearance. And back to plan A. So, is Doug going to be sorry that he left black at hoop 4 with red set up to make hoop 2?
Like Florida.
Whoa, I think you got it.
Nice.
Good job. You don't miss, don't you?
That is a spectacular shot. Could be the start of something big. I think he's checking to see if blue has a shot, because if not, then he can safely put yellow at hoop four, and red with a rush to its hoop off black can get a three ball break going. So that missed hoop shot at Pinault by black is giving Tim the chance to get back in this game that he's been waiting for. There's more interactivity in this game than you might have expected in a semifinal. Translated, they can't make a hoop to save their souls.
Appreciate it, sir.
I'll send you the bill.
Okay.
Oh, well. I don't know, Ron. I might get Bill.
Oh, well, oh, well.
I'm going to try cutting right over to you.
I had a good thing going. You want to watch it? I had a good thing going.
Put them over there and I'll probably not cut them, right?
Okay. Doing something wrong.
I went on, decided what kid I wanted to go on, but couldn't guarantee it, you know?
And the curse continues. Thank you. The board hasn't changed. I just want somebody to explain to me why he's not moving blue. Tim's a little taken aback, I think.
Clearing black and blue.
Yet another laid break, thwarted by an uncharacteristic mistake by both players. Yellow is for hoop four and clean on partner. And another go at penult coming up.
Who's winning in the David Isaac game?
I don't know. I'm following you guys.
Out.
wish I could do that. Yeah, I do. Yeah, I need to meditate or something. I have a good opportunity. I'm just putting it on.
Reds for one back and only dead on yellow. So if you can get black over there. Pretty close to blue, but the risk is worth taking because blue would be three ball dead and a long way from its hoop if it hit yellow.
The need to be watched. That's because it's on the stanchion.
I underestimated Mr. Moore.
Yeah, so.
The break would have been better, but that was impressive.
It's been a nice turn. You guys put on a really nice turn.
Thank you.
I'm not sure why he's not going for it, because five is blue's hoop. Maybe because he's ahead by four hoops and he doesn't want to get down by red and get stuck. And again, the board hasn't changed. This is just for tactical reference. A little bit of boundary roll off for both of those targets. Back down to his hoop, Pinault. Yellow is for hoop five and three ball down. And still three ball down. He needed the rush on black back to hoop six. And as he didn't get it, and red is sitting there guarding hoop six, he's going to spread his balls to the boundary. But he needs to be careful where he puts blue, because that's the only ball that red is live on, and he is responsible for red's position.
Happy, I'm the one that's going to make it happen.
So, red is Wired from Blue by Hoop 6. And the wire is conceded.
Blue is dead on yellow, too.
Another fantastic roll up and hoop. Tim is playing like this is an AC game, building breaks out of nothing and showing no fear of deadness.
Thank you.
Since yellow's three ball dead, he's going to have trouble doing an unhittable leave. He's probably just going to either peel yellow or stuff it into his hoop. And blue and black will, of course, get a clearance. I didn't hear the time, but it looks like red must be first ball in last turns. Because he's not worried about getting yellow clean. Either blue or black is going to get a one back clearance, so he has to make sure they're not wired. And the usual maneuver of putting yellow over by blue so blue and black can't join up isn't going to work because yellow is three ball dead. We're going to have to work on crowd behavior around the camera. They obscured the peg out. But we'll have to forgive Ryan Thompson, your tournament director and tournament manager, his time on camera. It looks like blue must have been first and last. Otherwise, he would have cleared blue and just joined up. Whatever the case, Tim Rapuano prevails over Doug Moore, 17-15, and moves on to his third final in 3 years in the Buffalo Croquet Club. Six-wicket invitational. His opponent will be Rich Curtis.
Yeah, you're good.